Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I'll be discussing with you postpartum realities. Fourth trimester, postpartum is not fancy. Any of the topic that you want to pick, I think it's perfectly suits this discussion that we're going to be having today. You know, the postpartum phase is actually a phase that most women, we are not prepared for, especially the first time mom. It actually meets you as a shock. All your assumptions, they will come out staring back at you and you're just like, wow, this is too much for me to bear. But I just want to discuss some of it because it's something that people hardly talk about, so that you can probably prepare ahead of time or prepare your mind that this is probably one of the things you'll be facing. So if you're new to this channel, please click the subscribe button. And as you're watching this video now, you already like this video, so click that like button. Thank you very much. So we'll just move to the discussion of today. The first thing I'll be discussing with you is that postpartum can actually be a bliss or a nightmare. It can for most women, it's like a nightmare. It's an horrible period that they don't want to discuss. And most women don't want to scare other women that this phase is actually very challenging, because everybody's happy for the new baby. A new baby is born, you know, but a new mom too is born, and you know, the whole burden of caring for a new life, a new human being, is actually on you. You are responsible for the cleanliness, for feeding, for well-being generally, and coupled with your own, and nobody actually cares for you. You are the one caring for, and people even still expect that you care for them that are around. You know, that is a lot of burden on the new mom, and I just want you to prepare your mind ahead of time. So most times, most people discuss about the there are articles online about pregnancy, about delivery, but you know, most people don't actually go in depth as to the postpartum phase. What happens in the fourth trimester? Actually, the experience varies for different people. Maybe that is one of the reasons why they don't talk about it. So the after your baby is born, most times, you know, your baby will have a dark pool, so it's normal for your baby to have a dark pool, and the doctors might be checking on the baby, conducting series of tests. You know, the first sight of having injection or something passed through your baby's vein can be very, very, very scary, and you know, but it's just for the well-being of the baby. But that's not the real discussion, that's just a preface. Immediately after birth, you are expected to poo or probably pass urine, and those two things is very, very scary, because if you have tears, you might actually have difficulty in doing the two. Not difficulty like difficulty, but you might actually feel scared doing those two that I earlier mentioned, and you know, it might cause a lot of discomfort for you. I read this recently online that someone said that my greatest fear was the first poo after birth, because it will look like everything is jamming together, and it can be very scary and very haunting for a new mom. Another thing that happens during the postpartum phase is that you still get to look pregnant. Most people will be, at that time that you have given birth, that is when people will now start greeting you that I don't want to speak my native language, like you deliver safely and all those things. You know, it's a form, the new mom will be feeling like, oh, I'm not back to shape. You know, there's this pressure to probably get back into shape, to you know, start looking like the way you used to. But don't pressurize yourself, that just enjoy that look. It's a glorious look, so enjoy the look for that time. You will probably adjust to the new life with time. Another thing, that one of the key challenges of the postpartum phase is having to go through sleepless nights. sleepless nights, taking care of the baby, you know, breastfeeding the baby, changing diaper, washing clothes, doing all sorts of things, attending to visitors. All those things can be can make the postpartum phase very, very tiring for a woman. And so just know that you are going to have a lot of sleepless nights. Sleep is like luxury for most new moms. So just prepare ahead of time that just get all the sleep that you can get in this world before delivery, because after delivery, no more sleep. Another belief that people have is that good babies sleep, while bad babies stay awake. Babies are just babies. It doesn't make them less of who they are. So your baby not sleeping in the night does not make the baby a bad baby. There was a particular public figure recently that was asked that hope the baby sleeps good at night. And you know, most mothers actually find that question very insensitive, because it's not the duty of the mom to make the baby sleep. The baby sleep at his own volition. So I think it was now later that someone was now asking that same for public figure that, how are you doing? And the person actually voiced out that, wow, thank you so much for asking. Because then that leads me to my next question. Some people might actually stop next point. Some people might actually stop checking up on you. They might actually, you know, most time when people ask you, the four of us ask about how is baby doing, how is that, we ask you for family, but most people forget to ask about how you are doing. So it's more like everybody is neglecting the new mom. So at that time, you might be feeling some form of neglect. Just be prepared for it. They are not doing it intentionally. It's just that probably they don't know. So, and if you are watching this video, next time you are meeting a new mom, please always check up on her and ask her how she's doing, how you can be of help or service and all that. Another thing that happens during this phase is mom's guilt. You feel if you allow your baby to cry for some time, you are a bad mom. No, you are the best mom ever that baby can ever have. So whether you try and take some time out for yourself so that you can be a better mom to that child does not make you a bad mom. You're actually a good mom. But we women, we actually suffer from lots of guilt, and they call it mom guilt. But just try and manage it. It comes, and we'll all get through it. And we are getting through it. Another thing to work on this phase that can be very, very challenging is you know, the engorgement, shivering. When there are times that, you know, as a breastfeeding mom, your breast will be engorged, and that can cause a lot of cold. Like, you might not even know you might be vibrating until the engorgement goes down. You might not get yourself, and you know, coupled with all other pains, the pain of from the back and all those, the different pains that happen, you know, you are bleeding, you are still not seeing the cracked nipples, everything is happening at the same time. And so it's just something that I want you to prepare ahead of time so that you can know that is how that phase looks. So the next point is to, at that time, you and your spouse or your partner might actually be having difficulty coping with the new life, because you are no longer maybe A and B. You are now A and B's father or A and B's son, A and B's parent. You know, you have become a parent, and that phase can really be challenging, because the whole attention will now shift. Both of you might actually shift the whole attention to the baby and not yourselves. And if you're not careful, you might start missing out on what is happening in each other's lives and what you guys need from each other. You know, you might not have time for yourself or companionship that you both have shared for a long time. So it is actually necessary that you pay attention to the relationship you have with your spouse, so that phase will not we make you guys come out better. So if you plan for it, you can have a better relationship with your spouse, even though the postpartum phase can be very challenging. Another thing that happens is that you might actually feel like, I just want to tell you that secret, you might actually feel like going back to the hospital. Actually, because of the whole stress, you know, you might actually feel like going back to the hospital so that maybe the nurses can take care of you, they can help you handle the baby while you sleep, because you are looking for every possible way to just escape that stress. And it's a normal feeling. I also felt that way. So, but yeah, I'm going through it, and I didn't go back to the hospital, by the way, but I'm going through the phase, and I'm coming out good. Every step is getting better. Another thing that the postpartum phase does for you is that it makes you interpret success differently. You might actually, there are times that, you know, I checked on LinkedIn, I see a lot of things, oh, this achiever and this and that. It's good, but you know, as a mom for that phase, before you get back to work, success might just be your baby's first smile. I remember when my baby's first smile, it was just like a peace of mind. I felt like some sense of reward for everything that I was doing. It was like you gave me a plaque. That's congratulations. So, you know, success might mean the giggles that your baby give you every morning, or when you want to sleep, or when the baby wants to eat or something. You know, success might be your baby being happy, your family being happy. So, you know, you begin to look at success more deeply than it is, than the ones that you are used to. Another thing is that success might actually be you getting sleep, because putting a baby to sleep and you yourself sleeping at that time, it might actually be success for you. So, but one of the erroneous things that people always advise is that sleep when babies sleep. I don't know how possible that is, except you have someone helping you. But most likely, it is very difficult to sleep when babies sleep. But with time, you can be arranging your schedule, be reviewing your schedule to see how you can also gain rest. Because one thing I realize is that if I'm not healthy, my baby needs me. Nobody can ever be a mother to my baby, but anybody can be any other thing to the baby, but I'm the sole mother for that baby. So if you love that child, you also try and get some sleep. You at that time, you have to overlook a lot of things that are going on around you. If your house is dirty, fine. Don't say that I said that. But that is probably how, if that's how you can get better, please just do that. Another thing that I want to discuss with you is that resuming work or probably picking up a new job might be more taxing for you, because right now you have to be considering, where will you put your baby, how will we take care of your baby, how will your baby be faring. You know, your thinking right now has gone beyond you or the money that they are going to pay you at that work, but it's more like you're looking at your family, the new life that you are responsible for holistically. So it might actually slow down some of your decisions and might actually change some of your plans. So it's something you can also plan and review before that time comes. Another thing that happens, that's the last topic that I'll be discussing, and that is the social media or society pressure on women. The society is putting so much pressure on women to probably get their body back, bounce back, you know. All those things might not actually be possible. So if you are looking at a mini-me picture on Instagram, and that is what you are looking at, oh, when am I going to get back into this shape, to fit in into this shape that was fine, you might actually be doing yourself a lot of disservice. So it's better that you accept who you are now, because you have changed, you are a new being, you are like you are renewed. So it's better to enjoy that phase, accept who you are, love your body, and keep on moving ahead, taking one step over the other every day and getting better at it. Postpartum, sincerely, is not fancy. It's not something that is interesting, but it's a phase that every mother have to go through it, and every new mom or former moms have gone through it, and everybody will just be fine. We'll get through it, and all of us will all be fine at it. But I hope these informations that I've mentioned will help you to prepare better if you are currently pregnant or you are expecting to be pregnant about this phase called postpartum, because it is not actually fancy. So click the like button and like my video, subscribe to my channel. I see you in my next video. Bye.